Welcome to Smart Brown Voices, your weekly podcast featuring diverse voices from around the world, giving you insights on how others made it big in their respective fields. Now sit back, grab a notebook, and get ready to be inspired. And don't forget to use hashtag Smart Brown Voices to share insights, moments of wisdom, and things from the show that inspire you. And now, here's your host, social media nerd and technology activist, Mr. Mike Street.
Hey, what's up, everybody? It's me, Mr. Mike Street, and we are back with another edition of Smart Brown Voices. Like I said in the past episodes for this month, we're getting close to our 100th episode. I'm trying to release it. I'm trying hard as I can to release it on my birthday, which is August 19th. So if you guys want to send me gift cards or cake or anything in between, trips to, you know, Costa Rica, I just got back from Costa Rica. So, you know, let's show me some love. We've been working hard on this show for the past 2 years. It's been a labor of love. And so just thank everybody out there for the support and making this show fun. Because I don't want it to be boring and I want to bring on interesting people. And so your support out there makes it all worthwhile. So today, I'm bringing on somebody who I, you know, ran into on the Twitter nets. And he has an amazing organization that I really want him to tell you about. So Gerard, introduce yourself to the Smart Brown Voices audience.
Thank you very much. First of all, thank you for having me. And happy early birthday to you.
Thank you.
Well, my name is Gerard P.K. Kersey. Like you said, I'm the founder of That Suits You. And basically what That Suits You is a nonprofit organization where we collect new and gently worn professional attire. And we take that attire and we work with job training programs, mainly throughout New York City. But we've sent items across the country. And what we do is we work with those programs and provide suits and ties and trainings to those individuals. Also, we work with public schools, charter schools, and colleges. We go in, we teach the young men about presentation, about image, about being ready for an interview. We also talk to them about starting their own business, not just working at a job. Maybe you want to be an entrepreneur. So we try to train the inner man as well as dressing the outer man.
Awesome. So give us, you know, the backstory. You know, how did you, you know, start from the beginning and tell us, like, how did you come up with the concept and, you know, what was your motivation and inspiration for creating That Suits You?
Well, basically, I'm born in Brooklyn. I worked for New York State Department of Motor Vehicle for over 25 years. And working there, I was able to see, interview actually a lot of men. Department of Motor Vehicle is actually, it's predominantly women. And so a lot of the men I saw that we interviewed, they weren't being hired. And one of the reasons, simply because they weren't dressed properly. And, you know, that really became discouraging that men weren't getting jobs. And one of the reasons was they weren't coming to interviews being dressed appropriately. And I found that was mainly two reasons. One, they didn't realize the importance of wearing a suit or dressing with a suit and tie for the interview. And two, a lot of them, they couldn't afford a suit. They're actually trying to get work so that they can afford these items. You know, a suit can be very expensive. So realizing that, I said, well, it has to be something that I can do to kind of help these guys get work. So I went in my closet and I got some suits and asked my brother. He did the same. And me and him decided to form That Suits You and just started expanding and reaching out to family members, churches, and businesses to kind of grow the organization.
Awesome. So give us some background. So are you, you know, you are a nonprofit organization, you know, so for our listeners out there who might be interested in starting their own nonprofit organization, what are some of the steps that you have to go through, you know, to, you know, from concept inception to becoming like an official, you know, nonprofit organization that can receive money and donations?
Right. Well, the first step was definitely having that why. Why do you want to start this nonprofit? Why did we want to start it? We really wanted to help men get back to work. And one of the ways would be getting sued. So you have to start with a strong why, because it's, you know, businesses in general are very challenging. So a nonprofit, you know, you're going to face numerous challenges. So you really have to have that why, that passion for you to keep pushing forward. And then what I did, I did a little research. You know, I had the why, but is it needed? So I looked to see, was this service really needed, or was someone already doing it? And I found actually a few women organizations that were strong in that field, like Dress for Success and Bottomless Closet. And but I didn't see, you know, that many for men. I mean, I saw a few, but none that were doing it the way I had the vision to do it. So so you do your homework and see, is there a need for what you want to do? And even if there is a need, you know, find out what makes you different, or if there's other people doing it, what separates you from the ones that are already doing it. So we did that, and we saw that there was a need. We saw that we had a different flavor, as you will, for what we wanted to do. So then we just did our homework as far as what we had to do in New York State. You know, we filed, we got a tax ID. Then we had the longest process was getting recognized as a tax exempt by the federal government. So we had to hire an agency to actually fill out the paperwork for it, because that it's a lot of paperwork that you have to fill out. And so we hired someone to do it. They did it for us, and it took a few months, but we were able to work while the paperwork was actually being done. And then finally, thank God, the paperwork came in the mail recognizing us as an official nonprofit. We'll be able to receive give tax write-offs for our donors. So that was huge, because it gives people an incentive to donate to us. So it's a long process. That's why you really have to have that passion and really be have that strong desire to do it. Otherwise, you know, you'll give up on it, because it can be daunting.
And the tax exemption that you got, it's called a 501c3.
Yes, the 501c3. Yes. So that really made us official as far as receiving donations from everyone, so that we could give them that tax write-off for them.
And the firm that you hired, what kind of firm is that? If someone's out there listening to this episode, what would they search for, or what was the name of the firm that you used if they're looking to start their own nonprofit?
Well, my brother, he's like, I work for New York State for over 25 years. He's actually been in banking for over 15 years, and he has a lot of clients. He's in business banking, so he has a lot of clients. So it's actually one of his clients that he does the banking for them. They actually do tax returns for individuals and for businesses, and they're also an accounting firm, so they have their hands in a lot of that. I can't remember the name off the top of my hand, but that was his actual connection, and he was able to do business with them to complete the paperwork for us.
Gotcha. And you know, maybe after the show you can send us their info, or if they have a website, and then we can include it in the show notes, just in case any of our listeners are trying to launch their own nonprofits and might want to utilize their services.
Correct. Yep.
So now let's get into the programming, because you said it's not just giving out suits, but you're also doing, you know, different workshops and programming so that, you know, the men that you service, you know, have, you know, the job preparedness and readiness skills to come in and be able to, you know, excel and convert with the, you know, with their interviews. I think that's a really important piece, you know, of it as well. It's like definitely looking the part, but definitely having all the tools necessary when you go into a job interview so that you can, you know, convert and win. So give us some of the programming that you put together for, you know, the men that you service.
Right. Well, we offer a couple partnerships. So if an individual is in the just hears about us and says, oh, I want to get a suit, let me contact them. It doesn't work that way. So they would have to be a part of a job training program. So we contact one of the job training programs that we partner with. If they provide trainings to the individuals, then that qualifies them to obtain a tire from us. If they don't provide training, some of the agencies call us in to do the trainings, and then that person will qualify for a suit. So they have to receive some type of training either by the job organization who they're attached to, or training by us. So if we do the training, then that qualifies them, or the job training agency. So when we go into schools, we have workshops, which we call right now, it's called choice workshops. And it's we break it down as far as choice, meaning change, habits, options, image, communication, and effort. And each of those sessions, each of those letters become a session, and we talk to them about how those letters impact every area of their life. So we do it's six sessions. Sometimes it goes longer, but we make sure that we give the students thorough teaching. And we also, during those teachings, we teach them how also to tie a tie. We take their measurements, because you'd be surprised if you walk down the street, ask the average man what's his suit size, he doesn't know. Ask a lot of men how to tie a tie, they don't know. And one of the reasons, because it has a breakdown of the family structure. A lot of times, I learned, my father was in the household. He learned from his father, but unfortunately, a lot of men, they don't have that figure in their household where they can learn. YouTube has become actually one of the biggest teachers of how to tie a tie now. Instead,
I was just
going to
say that I learned how to tie a tie from YouTube.
Right. So, I mean, so a lot of guys, they don't know. YouTube is good, but also we like to have that one-on-one just so that they can have that experience of learning from another male individual, showing them and teaching them. And so it's not just the tie aspect of it, but that bonding and learning experience.
And, you know, and especially since we both live here in New York City, you know, the unemployment rate here, you know, for African American, especially African American males, is, you know, it's very high.
Right.
And,
right.
You know, so definitely having, you know, being able to go to job preparedness programs, and also being able to have access to, you know, to a suit in the proper attire is extremely important, especially when we live in, you know, in this current climate where the job market it's highly competitive out here in New York City. And, you know, one little thing that's off in your interview, you know, can make the difference between you, you know, getting the job and not getting a job. I think right now, like in New York City, the unemployment rate for amongst Black males is probably like, it's like around 15%. You know, and so that's pretty high.
Yes. Very high. So think about that. It's a lot of men walking around with what are they going to do? I mean, we just did a workshop for New York City parole I think it was last week. And it's like 50 men in there. They released from prison and they don't have, you know, they're not working. And a lot of them saying, well, I can't go to interview because I don't have anything to wear. So that definitely can become a roadblock. So we gave away a few suits that day. We taught guys how to tie a tie. And just when we put the suit jacket on him, I mean, the guy was almost crying when he learned how to tie the ties. Like, he was like, wow, that's so simple. And something so simple, I never knew how to do it, simply because nobody showed me. So it's just that's what we try to bring to the equation. I mean, when we put the jacket on for the first time wearing a suit sometimes in their life, it's like life-changing, the eye-opener.
Yes, definitely, definitely. So what are some tips, you know, for anyone who might be listening, who's not an entrepreneur and they're entering into a job market, or they just got their dream interview? What would be your three tips to give them in order to, you know, do well or ace that interview?
Number one, I would say, make sure you arrive at a great time. You know, if your interview is at 10 o'clock, we always ask this question, what time is the best time to get there? So I say you want to be in the, well, knowing how either you're driving or the train system is, or commuting, knowing how the system is, if you have to be there at 10, make sure that you're in the area walking distance within a half an hour. So, I mean, whatever time you got to be there, make sure you're within walking distance of the interview for a half an hour, and make sure you're in the actual lobby or reception area at 1:45. So you don't want to be too early. You definitely don't want to be late. So you want to be there 9:45. So timing, your presentation, as far as your image, make sure that you dress as, you know, you wear that suit and that tie. A lot of, and this is the question we get a lot. Well, you know, the place I go, you know, it may not be for a suit and tie area, which is understandable. And that's definitely understandable. But this is your first impression and they don't know anything about you. They don't know anything. So this is, and we always also tell them, it's not, you're not just dressing for the job. You're actually dressing for your brand, for who you are. You are the most important ingredient in that equation. So you're dressing for yourself. So your image. And thirdly, just be confident. A lot of time, a lot of questions that, you're going to be asked, people are trying to just to gauge how you handle situations. How do you communicate, your demeanor? So just be confident and be yourself, because a lot of times people get nervous. They start to stutter. They get, you know, sweaty palms. Just going confident, on time, and dress properly, and you'll do well.
And then I'll add on one more tip in there. I would say also, you know, after your interview, make sure you follow up, because I feel like that's a lot of people miss that, you know, thank you note or the email or anything like that. You know, that can often make a difference. You know, in my career, you know, I've hired a lot of people, and, you know, I'm always just looking for, like, you know, what, you know, is the candidate attentive? You know, did they listen during the interview? And then can they, like, you know, are they good with their follow-up? So the people who follow up with me and so, like, you know, and are really detailed and show me that they listen, you know, those are the people I usually will call back for, you know, a second interview, and more than likely will, you know, make sure that they get hired in the organization.
Right. Good point.
Awesome. Well, Gerard, how can the Smart Brown Voices audience support everything that you're doing? Because I know a lot of the people who listen to this show are professionals. A lot of them may have suits sitting in their closets that they might not be using. I know I do. So tell us how you know, we can support your efforts.
Great point. Thank you for having me on the show. Anyone who wants to support, definitely go to our website at www.thatsuitsyou.org. That's thatsuitsyou.org. And you can see the different ways that we can, you can donate financially to our GoFundMe account. You can, we also, of course, accept professional suits and ties, only full suits, not pants and jackets and ties, and they can, we look for volunteers sometimes when we have events, if they want to donate their time to assist us, as far as when we have big workshops or at a conference. So those are three ways that we're looking for. We also have Got Suits shirts that we offer online where they can purchase them, and that helps us to do the work that we do. So those are four ways: the shirts, make donate to our GoFundMe account, full suits and ties, and if they want, they can volunteer their time to assist us when we have events.
Awesome. Well, we'll make sure we link to your website in our show notes so that people can visit and definitely give you support. And thank you so much for reaching out to us on Twitter. You know, we were super excited to learn about your organization. I think everything that you're doing is fantastic. And, you know, I think it's a much needed service that you're providing to our men, because, you know, especially with everything that's going on with right now, having a job is super fucking important. So we need to make sure that, you know, we have all of the opportunities that are possible. And if anyone hears the cat in the background, that is our show producer, Tabby. He loves to always, you know, jump up on the mic when I'm recording the podcast. So I'm sure people who have listened to past episodes have heard our producer, because he's looking for some food right now. So Gerard, thank you so much for being on the show. We'll make sure that we, you know, give you some support with our audience. And so everybody listen out there, if you have a suit in the closet that you're not using, please visit thatsuitsyou.org. and donate. Or if you have time, if they're having an event, make sure you, you know, volunteer your time. They're located here in the New York City area. And that's it for this episode. All right, guys. So thank you for listening to this episode of Smart Brown Voices. And we will be back very soon with more exciting episodes. And like I said, my birthday is on August 19th. So send me some gift cards. I love Amazon. I always accept liquor. So if you see me out at an event, you can buy me a drink. All that good stuff. So we'll be back soon. And don't forget, like, we're, you know, once we're about to hit our 90th through 100th episode. So we're going to bring back all of my favorite guests and do some update episodes. I've been seeing everybody out in the community. So everyone's ready to kind of jump back on the podcast and give updates. You know, our first guest, who was Paul C. Brunson, he's just landed a new TV show on the Lifetime Network. So we're going to talk all about that and getting your show up and running if you have show ideas. So, you know, stay tuned for all of that. Peace out.
Thanks for listening to Smart Brown Voices with your host, Mr. Mike Street. If you like what you just heard, we hope you'll leave a review on iTunes and tell your friends and colleagues. Be sure to check out our archive section on our website for previous podcasts and make sure to follow us on social media. This has been a Mr. Mike Street production. Join us next time for another edition of Smart Brown Voices and be inspired.